Hello and welcome to Adonis Tech Tips. I am Richie and today we will see how to use select option in SolidWorks to select components. Maybe it will be in large assembly, at the main assembly level or maybe sub assembly level. So here let's orient this component to front view. Now this component has multiple sub assemblies and whenever you try to select with box selection, you could see that all the selection happens properly. Now notice that when you open the subassembly, the components of the subassembly are not selected at all. So here we have the select option. In the select option, you have multiple selections, predefined presets available. So if you do select all, it is just like box selecting the component and it does not select the components inside the subtree. Then we have volume select, so you can select a box and create a volume and drag the corner edges. So you can create a volume and click OK. So whatever inside the volume is there, it will get selected. So you can see here the components are selected properly. Then you can either select one of this and hide. Okay, so here what we can do is we can create a display state and rename it as without box cooker. So double click here and you have the volume select. Now we have hidden some of the components. So in the select option, so first show the model view. In the select option, you have something called a select hidden. You can see here whatever is hidden is automatically selected. So right click any of this and make it visible. So you can see now the components are visible. So notice that sometimes we try to hide some components and then we have to find the component in the feature manager tree to show it back. So time is wasted. So with this option, your time is not wasted at all. Also, you can select only the toolbox components. So whatever fasteners are used from the toolbox library are highlighted. So here you can see the fasteners are selected. So you don't have to go and individually select it. And let's evaluate this assembly and let's find what is the mass of the component. Okay, so you can select the whole assembly and you get the mass of the whole assembly, or you can select specific components. So I just want to see what is the weight of the fasteners. So you can select only the toolbox components, go to mass properties, and you can see 96 grams is being used by the fasteners. Now whenever we select whole geometry, it does not select the geometry inside that. So for that we have advanced select options. So here you can select the category as document name contains sldprt. It can be .sldprt. It is the extension of the part. So here you can see once I apply, it selects all the parts from the subassembly. So even if I open the subassembly tree, it will select all the component inside that as well. So now this whole selection is complete. Either you can, you know, hide it or you can unhide some of the component. So thanks for watching this tutorial. If you want to see more such videos, you can always log on to YouTube and follow our YouTube channel, that is Adonis Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.